name something that has to warm up before you use it.
How about your wife?
Mary Beth prayed for snow on her wedding day.
No snow on my wedding day, but I had 8 inches on my honeymoon. So.
In what way is your husband romantic?
Oh, man, have you ever been made love to by a Frenchman?
Not that I can recall.
What is your favorite thing to nibble on at the movies?
Her boobs. I don't know if you...
Everybody, I'm Bob Eubanks, and welcome to the most outrageous game show moments 3. Now remember, last time out, we showed you some of the wildest, sexiest, and funniest moments in game show history. But we were just getting warmed up. You see, our researchers have scoured the vaults, and we've found even more outrageous game show moments. So here's what I want you to do. Sit back, get comfortable, and most of all, get ready to laugh. And what better way to kick things off than with a look at some of the worst answers of all time.
Name a reason you might stay indoors on a beautiful day.
Because it's raining.
Raining.
And you get this up your child. If you divorce and one person has it, they get...
Custody.
Uh-huh. And civil...
Shepherd.
No, civil...
Name a state with good skiing.
Florida.
Gentlemen, tell me, what is your favorite wind instrument? Wally.
I'd have to say guitar.
Name the most lovable breed of dog.
Kitten.
Name a city in the state of Georgia.
Alabama.
Pardon?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Alabama. Ah. Alabama!
Thanks, Rog. What do you think? Something associated with pigs?
The police.
Name your favorite male country western singer of all time.
Van Wailen.
Van Wailen. We got the number 2 answer there, Mary Jane. I'm pretty sure that it's Van Wailen. I think there's no doubt. Show me Van Wailen.
What will your husband say is his very favorite kind of rodent? Georgie?
It's a rodent.
His very... His very favorite kind of rodent.
His saxophone.
Name a pie that does not contain fruit.
Lemon meringue.
And apart from doors, we asked 100 people to name something that people open. Ross?
Bowels.
Smoke from your barbecue always blows, Dan.
The way of the wind.
Show me the way of the wind.
Hey, it's easy getting all of the answers right when you're sitting at home watching television on the couch. I mean, anybody can do that. The trick is doing it when the pressure's on and all of America is watching. We quiz some people here, and we put them on the spot just to see how well they would do. Now, all we asked them to do was to complete a simple phrase. Let's see how well they did. Put your money where your...
Where your wife is not.
A fool and his money are what?
Are my ex-boyfriend.
A way to a man's heart is...
Through beer.
Through a nice skirt.
The way to a man's heart is... People who live in glass houses
should never be naked under any circumstances.
A woman's work is never what?
Done right.
Oh. Grab the bull by the... What's so funny?
By the... How's that?
If you think those people were clueless, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Please describe these things associated with the word sand, and I've just told you you may not say sand.
Okay.
Ready? Go.
A sand.
The password is smirk.
Smirk.
Describe these words that begin with the letters S-T-A. Go.
Ouch! Oh, no, I'm sorry. With the knife, I stabbed.
Your safety belt.
Here's your buckle.
Your safety belt.
Fasten.
An old woman's breasts.
Things that sag.
This is, I just went a little bit off. Just
trim.
This is what you do. You do your peroxide is cold. Right.
7-point clue, Lee Mason.
Rubber. And this is some. Dear Abby is a.
No.
Oh, okay. Ruski. Another name for Ruski.
Where you would go to have a trial?
Courthouse.
Okay. If you're very wealthy, the top building, the top floor is the
penthouse.
Okay. If you're gonna have a good time, you go to the. You have a lot of.
White House.
No.
Fun house.
Yes. Okay. I couldn't think of anything else. Fine. What else?
I think we all know the real answer to that one.
The password is LEP.
Secretary.
I don't believe it. All right. Secretary.
Lap?
Yeah.
Don't move a muscle. We're just getting started. When we come back, we're going to show you some of the most outrageous hosting nightmares of all time. They give me goosebumps. We'll be right back. 10 different game shows, yet people will still walk up to me on the street and they'll say, "Oh, you're Bob Barker." All right, I admit it. With so many game shows, it's easy to get all of us hosts confused. In fact, let me prove that to you. Earlier today, we showed people here these three old photos of classic game show hosts, and we asked them to match the name to the face. You think it looks easy, huh? Take a look.
Ryan. I don't know what's wrong. I don't know. I'm done.
You know, there's only one thing harder than competing on a game show, and that's hosting one. Just when you think you've got it all figured out, something invariably goes wrong. Here's a few examples of what I'm talking about.
Show, John Burgess.
Oh, I
who polished the floor?
The password is roll.
Ken, roll. Oh, I said the word. We'll be back in a moment as soon as we figure out what we're gonna do here. Cloth. Now, really, Bobby, that's the first time I've ever done that. Really, isn't it the first time? Honest to God, it's the first time. I hope it's the last time.
Oh, that hurt.
I've never seen anybody knock the tip off before.
Did you get what you wanted for Christmas?
No, considering I'm Jewish.
Oh. Did you get what you wanted for Christmas? Skim over that, but I gotta give it. That was good. That was good, Jason. Yeah. Well, what'd you get for Hanukkah?
Nothing yet. It's not that time of the year yet,
Jason. Oh, good. Yeah.
And you know, Peter Pan is made to stay good as gold, fresh and moist, any time at all, from the first big swoop off the top of the jar right down to the last little bit at the bottom. So for happy young faces, at all times, make sure you've got Peter Pan peanut butter on hand at bedtimes, all times. Or do you?
Now, before we play Golden Medley, let's take a look at Carolyn Tobin in our gold room just off stage. Hello there, Carolyn.
Hi.
Now, Guard Addis, will you please open the safe? He will now dial the final digit in the combination and open the safe. And when he does that, Carolyn, I want you to reach in there, and there will be a wheel. And Guard Addis, could you open the door, please? He locked. He forgot the combination.
Coming up next, some hilarious game show moments that are definitely too hot for TV. But we're going to show them to you anyway. Welcome back to the most outrageous game show moments 3. I don't get it. Why would someone appear on national television on a game show with some host with big hair and big teeth and say things that they wouldn't say in the privacy of their own bedroom? I mean, they're either gluttons for punishment or they just don't realize what they're saying until it's too late. Let's take a look at these Freudian slips and you'll see exactly what I mean.
Will your husband say you would complete this sentence? My husband is the first man I ever heard about who... what?
He lasts so long when he's being... he just keeps... He doesn't quit. Can turn them on. But he doesn't turn off. He lasts. He's got, you know, he's thin, but he's strong.
Mom number 3, what is there about your daughter that reminds you of yourself when you were dating?
Well, there's not too much that reminds me of myself when I was dating. Except maybe she likes to park.
How long have you known this?
Oh, for at least 2 years.
And pop is called?
Soda.
And Lysol is a?
A disinfectant.
And I like to put some of this stuff all over you. And
shaving cream.
Yeah.
Next question, gentlemen. What is the one thing the people on the other side of your street have more of than you do?
Cars.
Cars. Your wife said they have more grass than you do.
No grass. What have you done?
I wouldn't bet on that.
Mary Beth prayed for snow on her wedding day.
Yes, I did. It was 32 degrees and no snow on my wedding day, but I had 8 inches on my honeymoon. So.
Ladies, if the law said that all married men had to take a second wife, who would your husband make a play for? Niecy.
Antoinette.
Who?
Antoinette.
Who's that?
He got a baby by her.
Oh.
You always say it was an accident. Ain't nothing like that, no accident.
This ain't no soul problem.
It ain't no accident.
You know, you get off that now. He just asked you one name. That's
well,
all you
I
tell
told him the name. And that ain't no accident, honey. Having a baby ain't no accident.
Could I see the card, please?
Man, she on drugs.
I know. One thing I learned from my days on the Newlywed Game is that no matter how hard you try to keep it clean, people always take it in the other direction. I mean, sometimes it's downright disturbing. Even earlier today, we asked people here the most innocent questions known to mankind. And I was disgusted. Yeah, I was disgusted. You'll see what I mean. Watch. Name a famous Homo sapien.
Richard Simmons.
RuPaul.
Richard Gere.
How big is your girlfriend's uvula?
How big is her uvula? I'd say about 5 inches.
I don't know. How deep is it?
How big? I don't know. All
right. What do you think about when you masticate?
When I masticate, mostly girls. When I masticate, I think about dogs.
What would cause your angina to act up?
A yeast infection?
Maybe it's just that time of the month, I guess.
How big is your epidermis?
6-7 inches. 20 feet long.
If your boyfriend was playing with his shuttlecock, what would he be doing?
Something I don't want to know about. I probably don't want to know. I don't want to know.
Hey, you think that was too hot for TV? Watch this.
Sylvia Anderson, what do you do?
I'm a waitress, and I'm also a volunteer teacher's aide.
Do you like to play Password?
I love it.
Would you like to do it? We're all ready to do it. Here, I mean, play Password, that is.
Gentlemen, other than popcorn, what is your favorite thing to nibble on at the movies? Steve?
Ooh, I'm going to get shot. Her boobs. I don't know if you...
Bachelor number one, how does a girl earn a little star in your little black book?
When she puts her hand in my pocket and grabs my rocket and shoots the stars.
I don't believe that.
Name something that has to warm up before you use it, sir.
How about your wife?
Bachelor number one.
What's your favorite thing to do to torture your parents?
Actually, my mother was Welsh and my father was Hungarian, which makes me well hung. But anyway,
Kitty, how did you vote?
I went for number two. I don't think a bird like that would cost $50 to $200, even though he can talk a little bit.
Okay. Bill Cullen.
Well, you know, we have a rule on this show that if we have seen some of the people on the show, whether they're right or wrong, we can question but not vote. Well, I have to disqualify myself because I met one of those gentlemen in the men's room, which,
What does that got to do with this?
Well, I want you to know where I met the man. Because
is
you might...
How do you
answer Kitty's question?
How'd you know he was the real one?
He had his bird in his hand.
Mrs. Periwinkle said,
"It's tough being married to old man Periwinkle. No matter how hard I try, I can't get a blink out of him.
A rise out of him.
A rise out of him." She looks like a little old lady,
but I think she's Barbie Benton in disguise.
Gentlemen, at what time did you and your wife eat your first meal together? The day after your wedding. Don?
I'd say about 8 a.m.
8 a.m. She said it was 9:30 a.m.
Oh, come on. It was not. We were up early and out and...
We didn't get up that early.
We were up by 6:30.
6:30?
Yeah.
Depends what you mean by up.
Let's leave it right there, okay?
Okay, now Daddy's gonna have to put the coat right over that. And then keeping your hands in your pockets, but working from inside, get the Bobo up and out of here. Are you ready? Go.
Watch your dad. Just go ahead, boy. Just keep her going. That's it. Keep pushing.
Coming up next, some of Game Show's funniest practical jokes. You're not going to want to miss this. We'll be right back. About it, and you know, I'm positive people are smarter than we've been giving them credit for. I mean, they have to be. Maybe the questions we've been asking here are just a little too hard. Got an idea. Let's make it simple and ask a really easy one. Here's one. Who's the Vice President of the United States? Surely everyone knows that one, right? Who's the Vice President of the United States?
Al Gore.
Bob Dole.
The guy that doesn't know how to spell potato. What's his name?
Let me think.
Oh, I can see his face. I can't think of his name.
Vice President.
Yeah, you know, George Bush is the president.
What's the guy's name? I have him at the tip of my tongue on it. His name is,
Dick. Dick, that's the name. I know his name is Dick. Last name. Last name, that could be like, Williams.
We just saw some really dumb answers. Surely it couldn't get any worse, could it?
It's something you buy in a larger size if you have a large family.
Jeans.
Name a non-living object which has feet. Caroline.
Plant.
A plant.
Name a kind of attraction you see in almost every parade.
Merry-go-round.
Merry-go-round.
Name a part of the body everybody has only one of. Sarah.
Big toe.
Besides Bond, name any character from a James Bond movie.
In every James Bond movie, he always has a number one lady. And I think her name was Julie.
Okay. Now, any character from a James Bond movie.
Come on, Joni.
Carol.
How many decades will your husband say his mother has lived? Gloria.
10 decades.
Gentlemen, how many decades has your mother lived? Daryl, you have a troubled look on your face. What's the matter?
Oh, I don't know what a decade is. 44th birthday, so she'd be
good.
At 4 years a decade, she'd be 10 decades.
10 decades.
Name an animal with really good sight, and you said a bat. 10 or 30 cents. Well, that's because they keep crashing into walls and nobody says.
Darling, what do you think? A product? It's designed to wear out in a certain period of time.
An iron.
All appliances are up there. See with the word appliance up there?
That's not an appliance?
Yeah, it is. An iron?
Yes, an iron.
It's an appliance.
Well, I thought so.
Yeah. So give me another answer.
Oh, so I'll give you another answer?
Yeah.
Freezer?
So all appliances. That'd be like your blenders and your toasters, your coffee pots and your can openers, your microwave ovens, I guess, your stoves. Yeah, that would all be together, huh?
Oh, I see the appliances is up there. I'm sorry.
That's all right.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. I just don't want you to be confused. Now, we want you to give us a product designed to wear out in a certain period of time.
Tires.
There are.
Game shows are all about fun, but not everyone is always in on the joke. There's nothing more outrageous than surprising some poor unsuspecting host or panelist with a good old-fashioned practical joke. Watch these next targets who never saw it coming.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Detective Richard Buggy.
Number two.
My name is Richard Buggy.
Number three.
My name is Richard Buggy.
The votes are in. Will the real Detective Richard Buggy please, sir, stand up? No! Let's find out who your imposters are, Detective Buggy. Number two, would you tell us what your name is and what you do, please?
My name is Chris Hart, and my mother is the charming panelist, Kitty Carlisle.
Let's go down the line. Number three, now that we've had our fun, what is your real name, please, and what do you do?
My name is Joe Garagiola, Jr.
To me.
Hi.
Okay, here's what we're going to do. I've got one more question. I'm going to ask it. If it brings enough points, 43 points, and there are 200 points, we're going to dance up and down because you've got $10,000, but we're going to leave your sister off stage. And then we're going to reset that clock and bring her back out and make her think she needs to get 180 points.
Our survey set.
Everybody settle down. All right, just bring her this way. Don't let her look at the clock. It's not looking good, Glenda. There's a lot of number one answers there. Your partner only came up with 18 points. You need 182 points for the $10,000.
Okay.
You can do this. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck. There were three stooges named Curly's wife. Quickly. What was the name of Little Orphan Annie's dog?
No.
Quickly, give me a number between 3 and 5.
4.
Name something you do when you're angry.
Cry.
Name a handsome game show host.
You.
Okay, turn around. Look quite your partner now.
Bert, earlier in the week, you told us that you were half Indian. Would you please spell reservation?
I don't think that's funny, Tom.
I don't either.
I mean, are you calling me a name or something? Or?
No, sir.
Because if you are, I'm going to take your head off and spit it. No, they don't like that, Tom.
Remember the great Jack Collins said this?
Oh, we treat you well on this show. Stroganoff, dig in and enjoy. Alrighty, now let's meet the person who specializes in unusual dishes. I, Terry Arnell, maintain that meat prices are much too high. Fortunately, I've hit on an ingenious, money-saving, palate-pleasing plan. Take, for example, my glorious beef stroganoff, which the panel is eating now. Not only is the meat in my stroganoff healthy and delicious, but also very reasonable in price.
Get out of here. What is it?
Why?
What?
Because it's dog food. Oh, no!
You're not gonna believe what we're gonna show you now.
Well, what way is your husband romantic? Assuming that he is.
Oh, man, have you ever been made love to by a Frenchman?
Not that I can recall.
About this show, we have talented people like the Ramiro family on our show. Paul is a concert pianist. Steve, what do you do?
I sell frozen bull semen for artificial insemination.
All right, Steve. It's always nice talking to you. I'm sorry we don't have time for a demonstration.
Describe for Patty these things associated with yogurt.
It's got stuff that's good for your bones.
Calcium.
Uh-huh. And,
culture?
Eli, what's the worst thing a player can do in your favorite sport?
Well, my favorite sport is playing basketball.
What's the worst thing a player can do?
I guess it would be the worst thing not to throw, you know, not to have my English, I'm telling you, it's a little bit hard. My Spanish is better.
Well, go ahead and tell me in Spanish.
I don't speak Spanish at all.
We asked 100 women, name something women borrow from each other. Chris.
One another's husbands.
Their husbands, Chris.
You never know, man.
You never know?
Never know.
You think that made the survey?
No.
I'm playing my...
Tambourine?
Yes. I take wrap rubber bands around my t-shirt and stick it in...
Tie-dye?
Yes. These are the ugly sandals that lesbians wear.
Birkenstocks.
Yes. Yes.
Veronica, I understand that at one time you wanted to become a mortician.
He made me quit, my husband.
Why?
Well, he didn't appreciate my sense of humor. I put an ear in his lunch one time because we got in an argument. And,
when we come back, you'll see what happens when everything, and I do mean everything on a game show, goes wrong. But first, you recognize this famous person? We'll tell you who it is when the most outrageous game show moments 3 returns. Welcome back to the most outrageous game show moments 3. Now, before the break, I asked you if you recognize this person. Did you figure out who it is? Let's see who some of the people here thought it was.
Gabe Kaplan from Welcome Back, Kotter.
I think this is James Garner from The Rock Revival.
Wasn't he the teacher on Room 222?
He looks like somebody that played off Planet of the Apes.
He looked like Bob Marley to me with a clip of dreadlocks.
Just like my father.
But...
Now, they were way off base. Do you know who this is? Believe it or not, this is a photo of a very young Alex Trebek, better known as the host of Jeopardy. You know, every now and then, something happens that throws a perfectly good game show completely off course. Suddenly, the rules are tossed out, and the game takes on a strange life of its own. Here's a few perfect examples of when good games go bad.
Name a specific food with an edible skin.
A banana.
Oh!
What's wrong with that?
What's wrong with it? We got a banana here. Which one would you like?
I'll take this one.
All right, here we go. Sure, you spit it out after I'm half dead here.
Beth, you have to. I did it. You want to show me how?
Show you how?
Be our guest.
Oh, good.
Watch it. Hold it. Take her off. Take her off.
This time you're back with it.
Oh!
Are you all right? No, no, don't be good. What happened was she fell in my hole. You see?
It's always
and now Barbara, she's trying to get her hands on some of that bonus item as well. Hurry up, Paul, hurry up. We're running out of time, shoppers. The countdown's underway. Here comes Michelle. Watch out!
Dumb Dora is so dumb.
How dumb is she?
I'll tell you how dumb she is. She sent her cultured pearls to blank.
School.
School.
Or even a state university college.
State university. What did you get, Beverly?
Finishing school.
Finishing school is another one. That's four for him.
School finishing.
School of finishing.
What?
Wait a minute.
School.
Now wait just a second. Will everybody just shut up for a second?
You're telling me the word college is
college?
Better than school?
School?
Hold everything
oh,
now.
No, wait.
No, I'm
Let's
sorry.
No,
we
I'm
not
sorry.
Take care.
School.
I can't believe it. Patty, would you show us your answer?
Stop.
Quiet. Would you show us your answer, my dear?
I'm afraid.
Got you, sir.
Shut the ears down.
Night school.
Night school.
Tonight's most outrageous game show moment has got to be Gilbert Gottfried one night on Hollywood Squares. Now, let me set the scene for you. Every square had an X or an O except for Gilbert's. All the contestant had to do to win the game was to correctly agree or disagree with Gilbert's answer. Sounds easy, right? Not on that night. Welcome back to maybe the longest first $1,000 game we've ever had.
Gilbert Gottfried.
Gilbert Gottfried! Okay! For a five-square win.
Oh,
Gilbert, Playgirl Magazine's clinical sexologist, says, I think we should be able to talk about sex the way we talk about what?
I'm going to say food.
I'll disagree.
Food. All right. Now, Valerie, where are you going?
Gilbert Gottfried for the win.
What a surprise. Okay. Gilbert, in a poll, 94% of Hungarians, compared to only 46% of Americans, said doing this was necessary to feel fulfilled.
Having a child.
I disagree.
You fool.
Having a child is correct,
oh,
David.
Oh, my
Gilbert Gottfried! Yeah. When she heard that Phileas Fogg had done it in 80 days, journalist Nellie Bly beat him by doing it in 72 days. What did she do?
This is rowing the Atlantic.
I'm gonna agree.
You fool!
Gilbert Gottfried!
Yes,
the tube top!
I agree!
You fool! It's the last perfect pitch game.
I'm gonna agree.
You fool!
Oh!
Valerie, your turn.
Gilbert Gottfried for the
yeah.
win.
The Crusher.
I'll agree.
You fool!
All right, Officer Dave.
Gilbert Gottfried for the win.
Gilbert Gottfried for the win. The word smog comes from what two words?
Smoke and fog.
Smoke and fog.
I'm gonna agree.
Smoke and fog!
That's the end of our show, everybody. Thanks for playing. I'm Bob Eubanks, and we'll see you next time on the most outrageous game show moments. Good night.